10 seconds remain. Radiant team ban. Remaining.
You heard it. 10 seconds ago. I'm Luminous, and you're joining me for the Summit 5C Qualifier Phase 1, and this is the Grand Finals. Warriors Gaming versus Execration. It'd be a hell of a matchup. I think both of these are arguably the best two teams out of the eight that you saw playing. Obviously, Mineski would like to question that, but Execration made some amazing comebacks against Mineski, and that's why they earned themselves a spot in the finals. Whereas Warrior Gaming, well, they had an easier path, in my opinion. They defeated Rave quite easily, actually. And then they 2-0'd their quarterfinal opponents as well. So to me, this is actually their first major challenge. Can they take down Execration? And the winner of this best of three series will get to move on to phase two, where they'll face the like of Fnatic, MVP Phoenix, and other major C teams. So, I believe TNC is also in there. I could double check. I'll double check right now, so I don't give false information. Phase 2 is Dire team Winter Wyvern. Peter's loading. Radiant team Fnatic, TNC, and MVP, yeah. So, winner of this set will have the first game against Fnatic, so that should be quite interesting. All right, let's talk about the draft as it is on the way. Winter Wyvern as the first pickup. Warriors Gaming. So yesterday, Afu was playing this hero, and he's really shown that he's extremely proficient on the hero. So as a fellow Winter Wyvern player myself, I'm glad that he thinks the hero is first pick worthy, especially in this metagame where Slaughters and Dooms and Bounty Hunters are generally the first pick for a lot of teams. And it seems like Execration will never get Earth Spirit on Tims, because every team playing against Execration has been banning out Earth Spirit. It is one of his best heroes. And, well, this game he might be playing the Witch Doctor alongside the Doom. Actually, he's the Doom player, I think. Then Kimo plays the Witch Doctor. So Execration gonna open things up with two supports. Warrior Gaming could maybe think about picking up a core. The other very popular offlane for both of these teams is the Darkseer, which unfortunately, it's banned out of this game, but would not surprise me if it gets slipped through in one of these series down the road. Alchemist. And if you're wondering why I don't have a co-caster today, there was some scheduling issues, so unfortunately, all you get is me. Feel free to mute or feel free to enjoy. I don't know which camp you're in, but I'll do my best to cast this game. And this is going to be Alchemist coming out here. So yesterday, when Warrior Gaming picked the Alchemist, picked it alongside a Naga Siren. Because Naga Siren was the Radiance holder of that game, the Alchemist player who was Nana, he actually went with a Armlet, Solar Crest, SMY, Blink, AC, BOTs, like, or no, Power Treads. And he got all of that in like 20 minutes, so that's kind of the insane thing is, you know, nowadays when we see Alchemist, we see the more traditional Radiance farming build, but you know, these guys kind of took a page out of the OG playbook and ran a kind of a fighting Alchemist that they're really known for. So my question is, are we going to see that style of Alchemist, or are we going to see the you know, the more traditional standard Alchemist? The other thing that to point out is Wargaming will take out the Ancient Apparition, a very good counter to the Alchemist, which I believe when Rave drafted the Alchemist, Warrior Gaming themselves got to pick up the A and countered it quite hard. Definitely protecting their mid Alchemist for now. I'm also very curious to see if Warrior Gaming is going to go back for the Alch-Naga combo. I don't even think it's a combo. To me, that game is like Alchemist could have definitely carried by himself, but had the insurance of even a bigger, better carry.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
A very interesting to see a hero not being picked to second base or banned to the second base. Beastmaster is quite of a hero in the current metagame. You wonder is it's because Winter Wyvern was already picked up. To me, Winter Wyvern is actually a great counter to Beastmaster. Because, you know, once you have the Boars and the Necrobooks next to you, you just ult Beastmaster and then Boars and the Necrobook commit treason and then they kill their own master. So I wonder why we won't even see Execration playing that. Because normally they do actually pick it quite a bit for RR. For now, they're going to pick up Gyrocopter, a very, very standard carry. A carry that's kind of like, hey, we don't really know what's happening. Let's just pick a good one. Deals well against both girls. However, I think the matchup between Gyro and Alchemist is actually quite Alchemist favored in the sense that Fall Down's it's a pretty nice kind of AoE damage spell in the early game. But to me, the way that you kill an Alchemist early is to deal with them with physical damage. And right now, Execration doesn't have too much of that. I mean, Witch Doctor has some, but assuming Witch Doctor actually gets a good ult channel, which I don't know. I don't know if that's actually happening. Cat is saying a bed is 7.5 KMR. Yeah, I think it's around that. It might be actually 7.8. I think the last couple days I checked, he might be 7.8. Ooh, here we go! Every team's been banning Meepo against Execration, and finally we're gonna see it. So, well, we're gonna see a matchup between Alchemist and Meepo. I don't exactly know who wins that matchup, and you know, the thing I brought up earlier is, if you want to kill an Alchemist, you bring the physical damage to the table. Well, Meepo's got both. He's got physical and magical. The poof combo is going to be there. I haven't seen a Meepo for a long while, so I'm actually really, really, really looking forward to this game. But one thing that Meepo's going to be very careful about is Winter Wyvern. I mean, the curse is going to be quite good against Meepo. And, I mean, overall, Winter Wyvern is just good against a lineup that has a bunch of units, right? Especially a bunch of heroes at that, so... This is actually a pretty ballsy pick, Meepo into Winter Wyvern. With that said though, it is quite good against Juggernaut as well as Clockwork, so they do have that going for them. Clockwork being played by Wynn yesterday, I kept asking, you know, when is this Clockwork game gank coming? Because he basically stood in lane for like the first 15 minutes, which is very, very non-standard, non-traditional for Clockwork. But he just farmed for his Blade Mail, and once he got the Blade Mail, he just got going. He got a ton of ganks off, made the game look extremely interesting. So for me, this game, it's like both teams got the heroes that they want. They got the heroes that they're good with, that they're comfortable with. And to me, it's just like, who has a better draft and who has a better execution. For now, I still like to be on the side of Warriors Gaming because I feel like Winter Wyvern deals quite well with Meepo. Alchemist and Juggernaut deals quite well with Gyrocopter. So I feel like Warriors Gaming's got the tools to really deal with Execration's trap. Again, it comes mostly down to Execration. We'll have to see. But Meepo Pickers, man, this is quite exciting. Yeah, and one of the things that you hear a lot of analysts and casters talk about is, if you're not prepared for a Meepo, you can just get completely ran over. One of the more imbalanced heroes in the game. And keep in mind that he's this patch, he got a 4 base damage buff. And that means when you have 5 Meepo, you got a 20 base damage buff. Wow! It's actually pretty good. Alright, the last bans are coming out. Bounty Hunter ban for the side of Warriors Gaming, and then a Phoenix ban. Side of Execration. I really like the combo of the two birds. Well, this is not a bird, this is a dragon. This is a bird. Actually, would Phoenix be like mad if you called him a bird? It's like, you know, Phoenix are pretty majestic, right? Yeah, let's call him a bird. The two flying thing combo is pretty insane. You curse and then you do a super nova on top. Not really gonna get a ton of damage out of the combo, but you guarantee a big AoE stun after a big AoE stun. So essentially stun for quite a long time. That said though, we actually don't see that combo quite often. It's kind of all like hit or miss. Curse doesn't initially catch a lot, then your egg won't pop and essentially threw two big AoE ultimate to do nothing. I think that's why we don't see teams run it that often. Alright, so the last pick here for Warriors Gaming. What did they run as support yesterday? I remember there was an Ancient Apparition. Looks like I'm gonna go with Lion, which is not exactly great in this game. I mean, Earth Spike is actually okay against Meepo. It's a good lockdown against Witch Doctor. Cancel his ultimate, but Yeah, it's okay. I mean, having some burst damage is nice, but to me this is kind of like your general, he's a very, very good support, so let's kind of pick it. I don't think he fulfills a very important role that the team is missing, per se. It gives the team a little bit of nice burst damage, which they don't previously have, so there is that. So we're gonna see the Mirana as the last pickup, and this seems to be a roaming Mirana. So core Doom, support Witch Doctor, support Mirana, of course, with the Abed carry Meepo. The over 7.5k MMR player. Let's see how. I mean, I'm sure a lot of those MMR points are from Meepo, so this guy should know. This guy should know. Ajit will be playing the Juggernaut, Tanana on the Alchemist, Wen, Clockwork as previously mentioned. I believe Afu will be playing the Wyvern. And last but not least, Zaki, or I would affectionately call Jackie, playing Lion. And R, of course, on the Doom. So, remaining. Again, I'm pretty hyped for this match. Winner gets to move on to phase 2. This is the best of 3 series, game number 1. I got my green tea ready. I had a side of pineapple cake. You know, I'm all juiced up, I'm all gassed up, ready to go. Good luck, Abed. Alright, man. Feels like, hey, I'm gunning for you. I'm coming for you, Abed. Here we go. Are we gonna see a smoke? Lion does have a smoke and the boots of speed to start with, so I wonder if it's gonna see an immediate smoke play. Now Tim's having the boots of his zone, no tangles whatsoever. Gonna drop a fairly standard warding spot. Because it's so standard, maybe the Dire team won't be expecting it at all. R does have boots as well. So that means poor Chemo. Gonna start with essentially everything and not have a lot of money for himself. Looks like boots Meepo as well. Man, everybody with boots. This like takes me back to like Dota back in 2004, you know, this is a pub Dota. Or it's like League of Legends. I think everybody starts with boots there too. I don't know. Smoke to just drop this ward, interesting. That's a fairly expensive way to drop the ward. And a sentry, okay, that makes a little bit more sense now. I believe this ward was also dropped with that smoke, I think. Yeah, because there's no way they would have dropped this ward without being seen if it wasn't for the smoke, so. Alright, Warriors Gaming, also boots on Clockwork. Damn, how many boots? 5 boots, alright. Let's see how we're gonna see that little tussle for the rune spot. Nano's gonna come in, he's gonna get pushed away. And here comes Nana, another push away. Abed coming in for the rune, the arrow is gonna not hit. And now, the rune actually goes to Meepo. That's very unfortunate for Nana. Rocket Barrage is gonna come through. Spin is available, and they're gonna go for Nano. Nano taking a ton of damage, might actually juke down the other way. He's gonna juke to the left, juke through the trees, stay in the trees. The cog's gonna push him back. The first blood now goes to Win. Ajit needs to run to the right side, he will. So despite the fact that the rune did go to the side of the Meepo, you know, getting the first blood is pretty nice. Arrow flying through the trees, not gonna hit. And it looks like Ajit will TP all the way back up top. Doombringer, though, will get himself the first creep and neutral, so he should be fairly happy with that. Alright, so I'm gonna pay close attention to this mid matchup. It's a matchup that we don't see too often, so I'm gonna be curious in terms of how it goes out. I missed the critical asset on the range creep, so the deny goes the other way. A ton of experience. Looks like these are potent Meepo players. They know, they understand, need a stack for the Meepo. In fact, they will. Speaking of stacks, I wonder if Nana will actually go for the stack steal. Walk in there and just, you know, drop an acid spray or two. For now, he's just comfortably hitting, last hitting on the mid lane. Meanwhile, lots of dewarding action going out. Meepo obviously, once he gets level 3, we'll get a second illusion. And now Warriors Gaming very comfortable dueling in him mid. Really don't think that this lane has any kill potential, considering that Unstable Concoction has not been skilled. So I'm not exactly sure what the plan is against Meepo. Meepo, okay. With Iron Tail on. A little bit interesting here. And there's a level 3 on the Meepo, and he's ready to basically stack for himself. When looking to get the rune. Actually, he's gonna let the Wyvern take the... Fair enough, Wyvern's gonna hit level 2 off of that bounty. Ooh, Mid lane looks like we might see a little bit of kill attempt here as the second in stair runs away from the arrow. So nicely done. Bims with the haste run up top. Nana knew that combo was coming, so basically got himself out of the way. And jumbo stacks. Looks like there was one successful stack here, another stack here. The Meepo basically held himself to a very, very quick third Meepo. And that's when things get a little bit scary. Arrow, not gonna hit. And this is really the big downside of a support Marana. When you're not landing these arrows, you're essentially doing nothing. That said though, you can play a little bit catch up by arrowing creeps. But not sure whether he should be arrowing creeps, because he needs to stack for his teammate. So as he arrows it from a bed's gonna get less experience and less go if he does arrows it. So another stack is happening. Meeple's being toggle back in the base. For now. Gwen's hanging around. Gwen generally plays a very farming oriented clockwork, which at least he did against the, I believe, a Crystal Maiden and Juggernaut dueling. I think against this lane, he's gonna have a little bit harder times in doing so. Rocket's gonna hit, the air will not, though. The cogs will fly out, and Gwen should be fine. I say that he's gonna take quite a bit of rocket barrage damage. The Black Hand is gonna come out as well. With a level 1 Maledict, he should. Yeah, I think he should be fine. But it is only level 1 Maledict. Meepo, the jungling has begun here, as we do see the Iron Talon already going to work. But I say the jungling has begun, but has it really? Because he's actually getting wrecked in the jungle. Speaking of the jungle, do we have any stacks? Yes. Wyvern dutifully stacking for his buddy, Mr. Alchemist, and he's already at level 5. So again, my question is whether we're going to see a traditional Alchemist build, or we're going to see the fighting Alchemist build with the armlet into the solar crest. I think against Meepo specifically, fighting build is a little bit more effective. Because one thing that Meepo does very well is catching people in the mid game. Once you get the blink dagger, you just blink poof, then they're just dead, right? So against like split pushers like Alchemist, I think the Meepo is a very, very strong pick. So maybe because of that, I think he's going to go for the fighting build. But we'll see. We'll see. Ims now invading the enemy jungle. Kind of just, I think they're checking for stacks. Oh, there are no stacks available for them. Check, because all of the stacking is on the left side. You know, for Afu's sake, I hope that when the stack is being done, he's there to get some of that experience, because right now he's getting no EXP whatsoever. Anna, gotta be careful. Basically one net and he's dead. Ooh, he's hanging around. There's gonna be Boulder Bash into gonna be net into another net, and here comes the cold ice embrace. Will he actually survive? The impale's gonna come through very far, not gonna be enough. They're gonna try to focus on the bed. They do get the abed kill. R now chasing down on Zaki, leaping forward, giving them a little bit of extra MS, but R taking a ton of damage as well. Tim's now have a creep wave on top of him. Mana Drain being skilled up here, and Zaki has to back off. Rocket Flare coming through, not gonna get anything done. So now we do see a little bit more of a reason why Wyvern's hanging on the mid lane, not just for the stacks, but also just to bail out his teammate. It's gonna be a 1-for-1 trade on the mid lane though. The Meepo squad getting the initial kill, the counter kill going toward Warriors Gaming. The other big factor to point out is that Warriors Gaming's got a much better farm safe lane, as the Doom can't really challenge the Juggernaut. Whereas the Clockwork is gonna be, yeah, he's laning fine against the Gyrocopter, so I think the small lead here going towards Radiant's Warrior Gaming, despite the kill exchange, and you see that Warrior Gaming is leading by 1,000 gold. There was a little bit of tussle on the rune spot. Whole bunch of sentries. Man, this camp is going to be heavily contested over. I do believe Mr. Alchemist will start heading over and take the stack. So, always like to check this. He'd probably not take it yet, but I'll drop it acid spray. He's at 3,000 net worth right now. I'll check when he actually kills the whole stack, but I imagine he's gonna get at least maybe 1,000 net worth from that stack. I'll keep leaving it on the last hit. First item, BOTs on the Meepo. Very interesting. Normally, I think players either rush Aghanims or Blink. But the BOTs basically allow you to rush your next item very, very fast as well. I'm not a Meepo player, and I don't see a lot of Meepo players out there, so I'm gonna take whatever Abed is doing to be the correct build. If he goes BOT first, I'm gonna say BOT first is correct. He's got it, you know, extremely fast, which does explain the Reeve's first build. Armlet's gonna be the first item, which is pretty standard no matter what build you go for on the Alchemist. You generally do start with Armlet first. Just very, very good stats, especially after. Ooh, Arrow's gonna hit with a Doom R comes in, and Ajit in a ton of trouble. His support line's gonna come in. Afu's gonna try to TP in, but not gonna make it in time. In fact, he will just cancel that TP. Now, Zaki will run to the left side. Sims does have another Arrow in 2 seconds, but no mana to use it. So, picks here coming out here from Execration. Again, gonna keep my eyes on the Meepo, who is also gonna be climbing ahead in terms of the net worth. So one thing that Meepo does extremely well. Alright, Acid Spray is maxed out. And let's see if he's gonna get the Rune of Destiny, the Bounty Rune. Nope, never lucky. It's a good old standard regen rune, and he's gonna continue to spray acid. Maybe we'll spray another acid before he leaves. Then you see that like Apu is just gonna stay here and get all of that EXP. It's as if the Wyvern is just doing the whole stack by himself. If you look at the way that he's gaining EXP, Jesus Christ, it's a ton of EXP. And he's extremely happy, and looks like we're gonna see a little bit of jungle invade coming out from Kimo. The smoke's gonna broke. And, well, Tim's gonna fire Arrow. Arrow's gonna fly out, not gonna hit on anything. Nafu should be able to escape quite easily with the fly. In fact, he doesn't want to escape. Well, Tim's is gonna steal one of the creeps, but will he pay? That's a question. Rocket Flare is gonna come out. He's gonna jump away from Zaki. Clockwork Hook's not hissing. It's a combination of hitting and missing. And looks like the rest of the camp will get clear out, as they don't want any more dealing shenanigan coming through. Nana dropping pretty low, but it's gonna be good. But you know, as Warrior Gaming is very, very happily taking the stack, they are also gonna be facing the Meepo infestation problem, which is about to happen. You know, Meepo gonna be leveling up fairly soon. Looks like he is gonna be going for Aghanim. So this is gonna be the... Both teams are gonna farm. Let's see who's gonna break the farming trend, as you were. Like, if one team is gonna make the big move, or are they gonna just both trading farm and thinking that they have the better carry? Well, I think Alchemist, in theory, is probably one of the best carries in this kind of situation, because you farm so fast. Here comes Zaki, leading the charge with a gank, of course, Omni Slash on Ajit. They're gonna go through the jungle and look for a Meepo. The Meepos are on the mid lane for now. Let's hang out. The Winter's Curse is going to fly out here. The Meepo is going to take a little bit of damage. And here comes Zaki. Impale's going to hit through. They do find a bed on this side. Omni Slash is going to fly through. Clean kill. RR looking for the Doom here. I mean, he could get the Doom off. But the Doom's going to fly out. Invis rune, so be absolutely fine. Key pick off here against the Meepo. Now bottom lane. Gwen doing his standard Gwen Clockwork playstyle, which is to not get ganked, just to stay in the lane, get the Blaymail, and then I'm gonna go from there. Problem is, I don't think Blaymail is actually that good of an item this game. I mean, don't get me wrong, it's very, very good against Gyrocopter, but that's it. It's not very good against Meepo, because you have like 5 units hitting you. It's actually terrible against Witch Doctor, because his Death Wards doesn't count as a unit hitting you. So, I'm not sure. Looking for the hook. Ooh, second clockwork hook missing. Jelly is actually very, very good at landing those hooks. I'm surprised to see him miss 2 in a row. And, you know, he had perfect vision. I don't think the enemy team was even aware that was gonna go for that hook. So, Gwen 0-2 for the hooks right now. We'll see if he's gonna land a couple of hooks later down the road. Right, again, I'm gonna just keep checking the net worth. 7200 gold here on the Alchemist. Looks like he is gonna be going for the traditional farming build. So, I think the farming build's fine. I mean, we see it work quite a bit. Not so good against Meepo, in my opinion. The farming build, you're gonna put yourself in danger a lot of times doing split pushing. And as such, you're gonna get caught a lot by the Bloom Dagger of the Meepo. Afu might get caught here. He's gonna, well, run into everybody. Calldown's gonna come out. Arrow's gonna come through with the Malefic on top. Clean kill going towards Execration. The TP's gonna come in from Zaki, but there's gonna be no follow-up. So both teams doing very, very good coordinated ganks, and This is actually a very, very clean C Dota game. So nobody making any big mistakes yet, and smokes make sense, and everybody playing extremely well. But we'll see if who's gonna be the first one to make a big, big mistake. Because a making mistake against either of these teams are very, very dangerous, right? If you give Meeple like 5 minutes of free farm where he doesn't have to worry about ganks, well, you're gonna see him pop out with like 2 extra items. And you can say the exact same thing about Alchemist. Alchemist may be a little bit even more dangerous in that regard. Smoke gank coming up top, but fortunately Nando farming with the not the smoke gank, Moonlight Shadow gank coming up top, but Nando's farming with the moon over his head, so the Dire team has 100% awareness of what's happening. You know, they're getting ganked, so not exactly sure if that was the best way of to use that Moonlight Shadow. Nana continue to farm away. Sacred Relic already finished. And the Radiance is going to be online too. So we're going to see a 13 and a half minute Radiance Armlet Soul Ring Boots. Damn, he's farmed. People is, you know, slightly falling behind now. I mean, he's got his Aghanim soon, but right now the Alchemist is unrivaled in terms of the farm. It looks like the first key item here for when is finished. Emails online, he could Rocket Flare behind the trees and see someone. Not gonna go for it. In fact, Juggernaut as well as... Well, Juggernaut reveals his position and decides to go for a push. I was gonna TP out and feels like he's not too safe, and in fact, they're gonna trade for tower instead. And then coming into the Radiant Jungle, wonder if he's looking for a stack or two to steal. He's not gonna find anything, unfortunately. Ooh, the Tins Mirana got himself a Midas. So I don't know how he's actually picking up this kind of gold, but he is, and he's definitely making it work. He's actually the most farm support compared in the whole game. I wonder if he's got a couple kills because of it, or from it. I don't exactly know why he's so farm. Especially when he's like kind of roaming. Ed has got himself Meeple, so we're looking at 4 Meeple right now. 4 Meeple on point. Fifth one will come in a couple of levels. We're not both teams just farming away. We're 15 minutes in and there's 6 kills. This is like some Resident Sleeper Chinese game right now, but I assure you, the explosion of ganks is gonna happen right about now. As Ajit is gonna get dunked on by the sword. He's gonna try to run away. Death Ward in a very, very good position. Ajit is gonna get caught. Very good gank. Booch Travel is gonna start here from Alchemist. And this feels like I don't know how many of you guys played Dota 1. But in Dota 1 there was a game mode called Easy Mode, and Zaki's gonna drop Impale, and oh, he's alive right now, and here comes the TP from Gwen. There is gonna be a Blade Mail available, and Blade Mail again, very, very good against Nando. Dando just got blew up. Damn, man. That's Blink. Man, these supports are so rich. Yeah, so in Dota 1 there's this game mode called the Easy Mode, where you got experience faster and you got gold much, much faster. This feels like an Easy Mode game, because they're gonna see a ward from there. Because everybody has like so much gold to work with. Midas and Mirana 14 minutes on a growing support, the blink on the line. And I wonder if they're gonna just set up a smoke gank with that blink, especially now that he's got a Finger of Death as well. No, more farming. I mean, I imagine Nana's gonna go straight into the Manta here. If you want, I've seen an armor build at this point, like let's say a Blade Mail or a Shiva's Guard. Of course, there's also the Octarine first, if you don't feel like going into Yasha first. So, we'll see, but it looks like it's gonna be a Yasha coming out. A very, very standard item choice. Man, both teams just agreed to not farm. Ah, so you might be looking at this and you're like, what's happening? Why are you actually getting a Dragon Lance on a melee hero? He's actually just getting the stats. It's actually one of the most stat efficient items. Gwen is gonna connect on yet another gank. Zaki is gonna hold his finger. And the key thing is they actually still have 2 heroes smoked up here. So they could go for a secondary gank. They still have a Blink Impale, as well as a Finger of Death available. Garou getting picked a second time, that's gonna slow down his farm. Speaking of slowing down farm, Ajit also got ganked a couple of times, but neither of these two cores, the Garou as well as the Juggernaut, are kind of the big carries for the team, right? That honor goes to Alchemist and the Meepo respectively. And these are essentially utility heroes, but think about utility heroes, I think Juggernaut is a little bit better as a utility hero. The healing ward's pretty big, he's a little bit tougher to kill because he's got the spin, he's also got the burst damage with the Omni Slash. First Garou, you know, kind of needs a lot of farm to be effective in the mid to late game. Hopefully for his sake, he's getting it. So he's going to go straight into a BKB. Maybe the tempo of the game is going to get picked up quite soon, which again would not surprise me. As looks like we're going to see a ton of Dragonlance stacking. Is that the build now? Are you going to just stack a ton of Dragonlances? I mean, your other Meepo gets the stats too, but don't you want something like a Blink or... Apparently not. Also, you can see Abed is constantly leaving one guy in the fountain and it's just like rejuvenating mana. He's just rotating through them. Another smoke coming out. These guys are chewing through their smoke. Looks like Radiant is out of smoke at this point and Dire also out of smoke. So they do have one in about 2 minutes. I don't think they have, oh, they have one more on Afu. So, and the Dire team does have a the smoke advantage, as it were. Execration though does understand that this game is going relatively late, as we do see two Hanamitas being purchased from the heroes. Tims with the Invis Rune scouting out just about everything here, just because they know they're coming. I actually get hooked. Oh, the miscue here as the both players going on chemo. Don't think it'll matter here though. So more than enough burst damage to go for the kill. And you see that Doom is hanging around thinking about coming in and assisting Tims with the kill. Alright, we got the next Meepo coming up right now. Yeah, second Dragonlance. So he's just building it for stats. I mean, I get the one. Is he gonna fill up his old inventory? Dragonlances? Is that the build? Don't know. Let's see. You could buy another Ogre Club right now. And he's got 2k HP. Maybe that is the build. So I think it's level 17 that you get your last Meepo. Yeah, I'm definitely not a Meepo player. Well, he's not straight up buying the Ogre Club yet, so I don't know if he's gonna be a Dragonlance. Yeah, I wonder if these two teams just kind of agreed before this game. It's like, hey guys, let's just have a game where we both farm. And let's see who can farm faster. Because it kind of seems like it. Bottom lane, the initiation is going to happen here against RR. The casket is going to fly out. Don't know about this though, as the dude's going to go here on Ajit. The hope is going to go in. We're going to need a big curse. Abed gets cursed, but there's no Meepo around him. In fact, they're pinging him out. They want him dead. Nana gets caught. Nana's going to get himself Poem Grace, but he's going to take a ton of damage. All these Geomancy strikes are actually going on him. He's going to pop Commander. He wants to fight. He's going to focus on Abed. Abed's going to be dead. Nana, two tank under his ultimate as well as the Poem Grace. Nana's going to take himself a stunned up, but there's healing ward available, he's got his ult on, so no worries here as Warriors Gaming wins the first big fight in this game, killing both the Meepo and the Doom, and not losing anybody in the process. Afu having a big part in that engagement here. Embrace, keeping Nana alive. Without the Cold Embrace, he would have been dead long ago, and that Meepo would have been running rampant. Virtue's gonna go down here, and I do believe that could lead into Roshan. Our team can take it down very, very quickly. I'm gonna check on Abed if he's gonna keep on dragon lancing it up. Curious. Meanwhile, Alchemist won't have any of that dragon lance BS. I see he's gonna going down and down his item trees. I think AC is next. Octarine is probably a good choice as well. Oh, he's gonna say goodbye to his trusty friend. Quelling Blade. Always feels a little sad when you sell the Quelling Blade. As you know how much work he has done for you. Oh. Illusion. Farming away. Well, 1600 gold. I think he's trying to save up for an item, like a big item now, other than Dragon Lances. Like a Blink Dagger, perhaps. But, don't blink inside just yet. You know, so, I was saying, last pick Lion didn't really fulfill any big roles. But the way that he's been playing this game, you can see how important that hero is so far. They're setting up a ton of these ganks on the key heroes, but unfortunately, I think he's about to get ganked. Aura's gonna open things up with the easy Doom. Oh, the blink of wake has Jao showed himself. The rock bonus smash is gonna be there. The Doom does not fly out here. Zaki's gonna take a nuke. The heal not gonna come through here, but Anna on the back position. And here comes Hulk. They don't have any detection. The BKB's gonna fly out here, and Aura's still invis up. No, Nana doesn't care about your BKB. He's gonna go in and right click you. In fact, they do get the kill with the force step. And here comes the Meepo. They don't have the Wyvern or the heal or the ult. And here comes the Omni Slash. They're gonna try to throw everything on Teemo coming with the ultimate. And here comes the buyback with the Winter's Curse. A bed dropping really low from his own Meepos. Ajit in a lot of trouble as well. And now it's Nana against the world. His whole team is dead. There's already a dieback on the Wyvern. Nana's gonna be dead as well. It's a full five-man wipe here in the favor of Execration, this time losing the Gyrocopter as well as the Witch Doctor. And of course, I think Wyvern bought back as well. Is there a way I could check that? No, 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 he didn't buy back. Okay, just kidding. I thought he was gonna die already. No, 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 sorry, sorry. Die first. Lion died first. My bad, my bad. It's like, oh, there's a support that died immediately. But no, Wyvern was still definitely alive around the kingdom. And you do see the immediate reply here with the gem pickup. Doom was definitely doing way too much work in that fight. That's the power of Doom, man. That's why Execration first picked it. But after a successful team fight, Meeple's up to a Blink Dagger and then 2,500 gold. I mean, I think before the fight happened, he only had like 1,700. Now he's up to like a blink and then 26. He made a ton of gold. He's about to hit level 25 as well. I wonder what his last item is. Is it gonna be a Hex? Hex is quite good here. I see Chad is asking why the double dragon lance is this. I mean, I think this is actually one of the most cost-effective way to get 15 agility and 15 strength. Or what, less than 2k? Yeah. I mean, it will only make sense if you're getting it like that. And he's not the first player that done it. I've seen Miracle get the... Was it on Juggernaut? Or on a melee hero, he also got Dragonlance just for the stats. So I think this is something that Ice Frog needs to change in the future, because this item technically is meant for ranged heroes, but the stat is so good that melee heroes are getting it. So I think the stat department of this item will need a nerf. Unless he doesn't care about the flavor fail of two lances on a Meepo. So he's gonna go for either Ethereal Blade or Butterfly. Probably Ethereal Blade to increase his burst damage output. Afu might actually just be dead. I'm just gonna ping him out. It looks like Meepo's just farming for now. Part of Meepo has done a relatively good job not getting picked off. I think he got picked off once, like over here. The other times he's just been mostly dying in the team fights. They're all kind of gonna come to scout Roshan. Nothing's happening. They are out. They are here. Man, this game is going everywhere. Now, the big difference here between the Meepo core and the Alchemist core is obviously Alchemist could farm mags for his teammates. There's some really good axe upgrade. Alright, I always love playing this game. So, I'm gonna continue playing it. We rank our heroes from 1 to 4, 1 being the first one to get an axe. How would you rank it? I think in this game... Clockwork is probably gonna get the first axe. The 10 second cooldown will really increase your teamfight capabilities. And then, normally, I'm not a big fan of the Line Axe. I think it's actually one of the worst Axe upgrade. But in this game, I mean, the damage against Meeple is not irrelevant. Now, Meeple is pretty resistant because look at how tanky he is, 2300 HP. But, you know, any extra damage, especially in a, you know, AoE finger damage, is not bad. So I'm thinking of putting him at number two. Now, Ajit would have a very strong argument of getting an Axe himself. Extra slashes does add a ton of damage onto Juggernaut. And normally you don't get it on yourself because your slots do get, you know, you do run out pretty fast on Juggernaut, so you don't have time to buy it for yourself. But if an Alchemist is going to buy it for you, just say yes. And last, unfortunately, Winter Wyvern's Axe is like pretty much a joke, at least for this game. It's actually very, very good for base defense situations. Oh, they find Nando. Nando's going to get Bling Hexed. And he's gonna get blown the hell up. Did it have detection? That's the question. It popped the BKB. Didn't finish him. They do finish him with the Omni Flash. And here comes the Mirana. He actually leaps away. Mirana will get forced back. Dude's gonna fly out here against Nana. But Nana, he doesn't care. He has healing going on. Where the hell are the Meeples? I'm not sure. The Meeple decided not to come. Looks like there was a gem hitting the deck. I think the Doom picked it up. So that could actually just be Rax here. They use essentially, you know, the big spells. The Doom. For no reason. And I'm not sure how they're gonna hold high ground. You can see Meeple is fiercely trying to split push as hard as he can, but push not very helpful here, especially against Alchemist, who could actually deal with split push quite well himself. For now, he doesn't care about split push. He's actually straight up pushing. No, they're gonna back. Jarl's back in 10 seconds, so go back and farm. They're very, very happy with killing a couple of heroes here. And Alchemist could finish his, I guess, AC or Shiva's Guard, whatever he wants next. Let's check in on Meeple. It's gonna be Ethereal Blade, so he's 6-slotted. I guess you could go BOT2 as your last item of choice. I mean, things like Moonshard is a possibility, but not very effective. So, I don't know. I guess, I mean, he's technically not 6-slotted, because these items, you could just sell it and then get another, like, get hearts or whatnot. Anyways, yeah, I think I was talking about Wyvern Axe. I mean, the Axe is actually okay for a base defense situation, because you could always Arctic Burn on the heroes. The damage do actually stack up quite a bit. Well, not stack up, but they add up over time, is what I'm trying to say. But in this game, these fights are being ended so fast. Nando is gonna get cursed up here, and all the right dire heroes gonna come in. Kale's gonna hit on these two, they're gonna hex him up as well. The finger's gonna be good, Nando's dead. And now they're chasing. Nana coming in against Chemo. Chemo trying to TP out. Woo! Close. We'll make it home, but you know? Seems like Warrior Gaming is not afraid to take the fight to you. On the back of, again, Afu. First pick Winter Wyvern, and we're seeing why, man. Straight up Winter's Curse, doing a lot of work. Ooh, they even want the Meeple as well. This will be a huge pick. Big set things up. Blink Impale, they will see him. And here comes the stun. Abed, he's gonna get completely changed. The Hex is available as well. But here comes all the Meeple. Can he actually beat all the Meeple? Well, for now, he can. Abed, you know, right click, he's gonna try to TP out. But no, all of them just TP'd in. The full gangbang, and the Meeple, unfortunately, is the gang that dies. Ajit now in the mid lane trying to fight his way out against RR. His Aegis is gonna get broken. Aqua Cook, though, is gonna come in from a mile away to get four staff out here. And RR on the run. Do they have protection? That is the question here. RR is still chasing. When? Oh, BKB's gonna get popped here. RR still running, still running. Four staff, Omni Slash is gonna be good. They do get the kill. It looks like the two Doomlings also gonna get Omni Slash. Feeds away like 32 extra gold. Thank you. Ajit says, and now here comes Nana. Alright, buybacks are coming out. Warrior Gaming, man, the gold graph, it was just even a while ago, but right now this Alchemist, too big, too fat, too strong, too fast. Blinking Pale here, Zaki making it happen again. RR already bought back down to about half HP. Now it's gonna come through here. Ajit taking a ton of damage. Okay, Oh no, another good curse. Nando gets locked up here. Nando gets hexed as well. They're gonna throw everything onto him, and Nando's dead again. Here comes the Meepo buyback though. Focusing on Nando. Nando rifles. Nando tanking the death ward. Can't tank the death ward. No, he can't. He's got the force staff. He's got the backup. Looks like Clockwork's dead. Another arrow laying into Nando. Nando loses so much HP. It's open at the bottom end. Nando's gonna be dead. No! He stuns the whole team. He's actually regenerating thanks to his upper ring core. He now turns back to the drop below. The Meepo's all gonna be dead. Meepo down! Meepo down! It's gonna be Nana taking yet another victory. Oh, he's not done. He's looking for RR. The stun's gonna hit. And RR is also gonna be a dieback. That's a dieback on the Meepo. Dieback on the Doom. And damn, this Alchemist. Too strong, too fast. That should be the game here, because this guy could break the base very, very fast. My god, look at him go. Look at him go. And this last item, Shizzle Star, might look like a very odd choice, but minus hex speed in conjunction with the armor really, really made him extremely tanky in that last fight. Of course, Winter Wyvern's max heal was a big part of that as well. We just don't know how they're going to defend without 60 seconds on their Nidfall. DKB on Nando. And, well, I mean, he's technically DK beat up, but I don't think they care that he lands essentially a Ravage on two heroes, stuns everybody. Chemo tries to run back to the fountain, he'll make it home. Warrior Gaming will let him out this time, but Midas, a BM Midas. I don't know if this is BM Midas, but he wants to make his endgame score look a little bit better. Warrior Gaming is going to force the GG out, and there it comes, Chemo. Gonna call it. That's game number one in the books, and Warrior Gaming off the back of an Alchemist. That one at that. BC Execration Meepo, which everybody has banned so far. That's a strong statement. They don't ban your best hero, you pick your best hero, and you get smashed. I almost call it a Keepo. Well, it might be a Keepo at that, because this Meepo, as fat as it looked, it was not fat enough. That honor goes to the Alchemist. Yeah, and that's game one in the book. Man, that was an exciting game. Game two is coming up next. I hope you guys are enjoying.